Because I overlooked you because you were on a different sheet of paper, so I apologise. Come forward.
I wonder if we could have a... Is it possible to have... Is that a table here? Yeah. Well, what if we could do something a little bit different?
For sure. This is the Christchurch City Council. We've had our first remote entrance.
Come up the front here.
Walked into that one.
I'm the mayor, I can do anything.
You didn't play Monopoly.
Oh.
Okay. So we're gonna play a quick game. We don't know we're doing a speed date here, so we don't have to play a speed Monopoly at the same time. And so what we're going to ask to do is we're going to ask the mayor, who represents Christchurch City, to be one contender, and Pauline Cotter is councillor for representing Shirley, which we're from the Student Community Trust, and so she's representing Shirley. Now, the competition is you're going to have probably only much time. You've got about 1 minute. We're going to have that much time, and what you're going to do is, mayor, you get $2,000. And Shirley, you get $500. All right. The game is, as you know, get as many properties as you can in the 1 minute when we start. Okay. We all see it, Roger.
Yeah, we're
right. Okay. Okay. My name's Graham. I'm chairman of the Shirley Community Trust, and Roger McCallum here is our treasurer. As you can see, obviously you can tell from there. And what we need to do is get as many properties as they can in the time that they've got. And while they're doing that, I wanted just to say to you that we want to acknowledge your investment in community. We want to say that actually you actually do a lot of good. And your return on investment, we hope, is appreciated. The reason we're saying that is that as you invest in community, communities are taking those money and doing a lot more. In our Shirley area, a number of the lead agencies like Shirley Community Trust, Belfast Network, St Albans Neighbourhood Trust, Delta, Te Oroho, are agencies that are specialising in community development work in their area. And we've seen from that, from a collaborative approach, as many joint ventures, that from the money that we get, it's been able to multiply into what we've been able to do to improve communities. How they doing?
All right.
Okay.
All right.
Come on,
Shirley.
Come on, Shirley.
I'm trying.
We've got Shirley Community Trust. What we're trying to say is, as an example, we. Usually of community groups. From that, we leave off that money, and we've been able to say, for instance, at the Shirley Community Trust, we get about 200k a year, 250 overall from all the funders. 30% of that comes from the council, the rest comes from all the other funders and so on, and what we generate ourselves. Then from there, we provide staff, we've leveraged off over 200 volunteers who are working in the community throughout the year. We have over 25 programs running, and we have over 15,000 people participating in the events during the year. That's for your bang for your bucks. So we think that you know, you are being returned. We're only one example, and a number of the other community groups are doing really, really good stuff. And we do it in a collaborative way so that we leverage off each other so we don't have any duplication of resources. That's the first stage we want to talk about citywide. That's stage one. Now we're going to close the door here and see who's the winner. Okay, how many properties have you got? Okay, Leanne, how many properties do you have?
I've got the waterworks, I've got the Fisher Street Station, I've got the electric company, I've got four roads.
Okay. Seven properties.
Yep.
Okay, so the city has seven properties. Shirley, how many properties have you got, apart from going to jail as well?
Yeah, she's on parole.
I've got Euston Road and Islington and Marlborough.
Okay, three properties. Okay, so here's the point from that little X-Ola. Here's the point from that little X-Ola. I'm going to get the houses out. Houses out.
Mind you,
Phil. Oh, where's our paper? Okay, we'll show the houses. Okay.
Monopoly.
Right. Our point from that is the same. The more resources you've got, the more you can do. And we think sometimes there's a disproportionate amount of resources going to different areas of the community. our example of shooting is we think that we've been quietly impacted by the by all the devastation of the earthquakes. We've lost community buildings, we've lost schools, we've lost church halls, we've lost sporting facilities. There isn't much happening in Shirley. We're a bit like the Old Kent Road and Whitechapel Hall. We're at the bottom, we're in the Browns, we're at the bottom. We actually haven't got a lot, we're not well recognised. When people get to go, they look past us because they're going off to Vine Street and going off to Vine Street, getting the bigger stuff. We miss out. And so what we're sort of saying, if you picture that monopoly board, what you've got in the middle is like the community resources, the centre part of community resources. And in our case, we're talking about the McFarland Park. On one side, you've got people who own their own houses. On another side, you've got the rental properties who are owned by private investors. On another side, you've got the state houses and stuff like that. And on the other side, an Nature Snag, you've got the economic development of Shirley as our little old shops that are driving the economy. So, what's the point of that? On one corner of that monopoly board, there's a piece of land that's been owned by the Housing New Zealand. The house has been demolished, and now it's a vacant piece of land. Right leading onto the park. And we're saying, what a fantastic place to create a new neighbourhood centre for the people of that community. Housing New Zealand said, we're open to doing a land swap with the City Council, and so that could be purchased for community benefit, and community could develop a neighbourhood centre on that site. Across the road from there are the state houses. 8 houses in that little area, but they're going to be expanded to 33 houses. So if you think about the community contributions, maybe 33 houses, 20,000, that's $660,000 of new community council contributions. Matt, perhaps part of that could go towards a new community facility that's going to help and engage and build our harmony and well-being for that community. And that's our submission.
That's a fantastic submission.
Yeah. Well, we rest our case. Thank you. We're taking questions.
But I did enjoy it. And
it's only because you won.
But I thought that throwing the dice actually sent another message as well. And that is that where our earthquake hit our communities was down to chance. You know, and there were people that were harder hit than others. And, you know, people can look at the east, and I live there, I know, that's been really badly damaged. But I could drive through that area every day when I go to work or catch a bus, and that is very damaged as well. And that needs our support. So you've made a really powerful position, submission, and let's not leave it to chance.
Thank you very much, and we just want to say we want to work with the council to see what we can leverage together for the benefit of the people of Shirley.
Thank you very much. Right, now, Council of Social Services, Sharon Paulson.